He's a legendary international referee, a referee all over the world. Refereed more bouts all throughout the world than any referee in the history of refereeing. Put your hands together for a gentleman, a scholar, and a great human being, this year's 2004 Hall of Fame inductee, Mr. Stanley Christodolou.
Each inductee will be receiving a certificate, and I'll read the certificate. There have been tens of thousands of people involved in the sport of professional boxing. Only a few are memorialized for their achievements in the International Boxing Hall of Fame. You are such a person.
Dear Director Brophy, members of the International Boxing Hall of Fame, members of the press, and boxing commentators, ladies and gentlemen, this is a great honor both for me in my personal capacity and for the sport of boxing in South Africa, which sees the first South African now inducted into the International Boxing Hall of Fame. I'm especially proud. Thank you. To be receiving this award in the same year that South Africa celebrates 10 years of democracy as a free, non-racial democracy. Thank you. In thanking the International Hall of Fame for this award, I must express my indebtedness to two major structures in boxing. First, to the World Boxing Association. Thank you, Mr. Jutras, for representing them today. The other world boxing organizations and the boxing control authorities, whose confidence in my ability and support over the years had given me the opportunity to fish it as I have. Second, to the boxing writers and historians from around the world who have proposed me for this award. I understand that only four ring officials have to date been inducted into the International Boxing Hall of Fame, which on the one hand makes this award special in itself, but on the other hand is also testament to the fact that the real protagonists on the grand world stage of boxing are the fighters themselves, and to them fitly go the laurels. I have been fortunate enough to, in my four decades in the ring, to have refereed or judged some of the greatest fighters and some of the great bouts in boxing. While every one of the 134 world title fights in which I've officiated has generally seen two great athletes at the height of their physical skills and powers doing battle, I must single out six classic great fights which I've had the privilege to officiate. Arnold Taylor, Romeo Nair, November 1973, Johannesburg, South Africa. Victor Galenders, Richie Cates, May 1976, Johannesburg, South Africa. Thomas Hitman Hearns, Pepino Cuevas, 2nd of August 1980, Detroit, Michigan. Aaron Pryor, Alexis Aguayo, 12th of November 1982, Miami Beach, Florida. Marvelous Marvin Hagler, Roberto Duran, 10th of November 1983, Las Vegas, Nevada. Evander Holyfield, Lennox Lewis, 30th of March 1999, Madison Square Garden, New York City. A ring official's job is no popularity contest. Boxing's success globally is its ability to transcend every race and culture and ignite emotional and passionate sport, like love. The support of most boxing fans is blind, and in the emotional charged atmosphere surrounding most world title fights, the outcome and the decisions of ring officials will often be controversial. Over the years, I recall being attacked with scissors in Seoul and needing police escort to return to my hotel. And in 1979, when I officiated at the first and only world title fight in New Guinea, in the public emotion at the loss of the local champion, I remember wondering whether my head would make it back to the airport with me. A ring official must be vigilant in preserving two qualities above all. One, concentration, the ability to calmly direct his undivided attention to the full 3 minutes action of every round, and two, uncompromising integrity, the unswerving exercise of his best judgment without fear or favor. When a ring official strays from these two sacred duties, he'll find himself quickly stripped of his credibility and reputation.